my dear friend. Today I am standing before you to express my view on the topic conflict between classicism and romanticism. As we all know that Jane Austen was influenced by both these ages because the period when she wrote this novel was the transitional period. Means the end of classical period and the beginning of romantic period. Therefore, with the influence of both these ages, she put the characteristic of these ages into characters in her novel. So, in this novel, there are two main characters, that is Marian and Eleanor. In both these characters, we can see the influence of these ages. First, let us discuss about the characteristic of classicism and romanticism. Classicism is the age of reason and prose, and whereas the romanticism is the age of poetry. So all these characteristics, this rational and logic, dominance of materialism, we can find in Eleanor. And the characteristic of romantic age we find in Marian. So these are the two main protagonists, Eleanor and Marian, and the whole novel was mainly focused on this character only. Eleanor exemplified neoclassical era and Marian exemplified the romantic era. And accordingly, Eleanor represents sense and Marian represents sensibility. When we read the novel, we come to know that Eleanor is very much mature in her decision, and whatever she think and act, she do everything with thinking, proper thinking, and she never take instant decision, and she was also successful in taking right partner, whereas Marian fails in relation. She just attracted on the look of Willoughby. But Willoughby cheats and dumps her, and afterwards only there's Eleanor who supports her in everything. And when Marian get ill, then also Eleanor and one of Colonel Brandon also supports Marian. Then Marian realized that she has to acquire some quality from her elder sister. This is not only the film in which we see the contrast characteristic of between two sisters. In Bollywood also we can see two sisters have different qualities. So in the film also Sita and Gita, there are two sisters, and we can see the two different qualities between them. Sita is passive and unclever, and Gita is cunning and shrewd. So in this way we can say that this is the very old archetype of making film, that film and novel also, that they show contrasting character between two sisters. Eleanor Dashwood, she is the moral center of the novel. Her character based on author's older sister Cassandra. She knows how to govern her feelings in better way, and she also aware of the demands of society. We can see this quality of compromising in her when she comes to know about that Edward Ferrar already married to Lucy. Then she manages and she thinks that now she has to step back. And if they are happy couple, then she is ready to sacrifice also. But afterwards, at the end, when she comes to know that Edward didn't love her anymore, and he is in love with her, so then she feels happy, and she also reveals her happiness. In the whole novel, she just like considering everything, but at the end, she learns something from her younger sister about revealing his emotions. And at that time, when she comes to know about this, that Edward was ready to marry her, she revealed everything. So, Marian Dashwood, she embraces spontaneity. She is very excessive sensible. And we can see that in the novel, she loves to read the poem by Wordsworth, and many times she sings also. So, characteristic of romantic idealism we can see in her. That point that she learned to accept fate from her elder sister. At the last, although Colonel Brandon is very much aged person, but she realized that he is only the right person to whom she has to marry. So in the conclusion, I want to say that by combining both this quality of neoclassicism and romanticism, Jane Austen writes his novel, but we can see that she is more influenced by neoclassicism, because in whatever aspect she puts Eleanor in a better way and Marion in a, we can say that in inferior position, and superior, she considers Eleanor as superior. So she, in this way, she also gives more importance to sense over sensibility. Thank you.